I am Razio.
What is up, guys? Razio here, and if you need any more proof that Blizzard Entertainment is no longer Blizzard Entertainment, and it is indeed 100% through and through Activision, then look no further than this article that released a few hours ago. I was streaming a bit earlier, and this came up while I was streaming, so I didn't notice it till now. But Blizzard Entertainment is starting to abandon their games. They're starting to pull people off their games for their mobile platform, as we know from the announcement that they made this asshole right here, J. Allen Brack, said at BlizzCon. So I wanted to go over this article really quickly because I think it's important. Now, I never played any MOBAs, really. It's not my style of the game. I never really played Heroes of the Storm at all. I had no interest. But this is a very, very telling sign that we need to look over. Okay, so why don't we go ahead and look over this really quickly. So, Heroes of the Storm news. This is what Blizzard says. We're constantly changing and evolving not only our games, but how we support and grow them. This evolution is vital to our ability to continue doing what we love to do, making great games. And it's what makes Blizzard, Blizzard. Except for that it doesn't, because Blizzard hasn't made a fucking good game in... Christ. I don't play Overwatch either, but it's very successful and a lot of people like it and play it. So Overwatch was probably the last fucking good game that Blizzard made. Let's be honest. You can't count Diablo 3. Diablo 3 released is a complete shit show because of its real money auction house and all that fucking crap. So it took them over a year, almost 2 years, to even get it to a playable state after release to where it was an acceptable game. Was it an amazing game like Diablo 2? No. Was it acceptable? Sure. What was it? What made Blizzard Blizzard? No. Okay. Again, this is not Blizzard. This is Activision using Blizzard's name. It's what makes Blizzard Blizzard. What that translates to, it's what makes Activision Activision. And it's not make great games. So if I rephrase this, what it really means, this sentence would instead say, this evolution is vital to our ability to continue doing what we love to do, monetizing shitty games. And it's what makes Activision Activision. That's that roughly translated. Okay, moving on. Over the past several years, the work of evaluating our development processes and making hard decisions has led to new games and other products that we're proud of. We now have more live games and unannounced projects than any point in the company's history. Do you know what unannounced projects do for us? Nothing, because they, by all means, just could not exist at all. Do you have any idea how many projects development companies start and then never even announce because they throw them out the window? I would say tens, if not up into the 30s, 40s, 50s a year. Projects that don't make it past the inception phase. They're unannounced projects. So this doesn't mean jack shit. We're also at the point where we need to take some of our talented developers and bring their skills to other projects, mobile games, I'm sure. As a result, we've made the difficult decision to shift some developers from Heroes of the Storm to other teams, and we're excited to see the passion, knowledge, and experience that they'll bring to those projects. This isn't the first time we've had to make tough choices like this. Games like Diablo 2, they didn't make it. Blizzard North did, and they left the company in 2007. World of Warcraft, they didn't make it. Blizzard North and the original Blizzard team made it. So nothing there. They still don't got shit. They didn't make either of those games. The company that it is, as it is now, did not make either of those games. StarCraft 2. Okay, they made that, but it's the game they released 3 times. StarCraft, each campaign was its own game you had to pay full price for. When the original StarCraft had fucking all three, they had 6 campaigns. 2 of each race among 2 expansions. So, whatever. Overwatch, yeah, they made that. And more would not exist had we not made similar decisions in the past. Despite the change, Heroes of the Storm remains our love letter to Blizzard's world and characters, which is obviously probably why they're getting rid of it, because, and not supporting it as much, because Activision has no interest in Blizzard's IPs that way. They don't give a shit about love letters to any of the characters. It's remnants of the old company. They want to get rid of it. We'll continue actively supporting the game with new heroes, themed events, and other content that our community loves, though the canons will change. Ultimately, we're setting up the game for long-term sustainability. That is translation to we're putting it on life support, much the way WoW is getting put on life support with WoW Classic's release. We're so grateful for the support the community has shown from the beginning, and the development team will continue to support Heroes with the same passion, bullshit, dedication, mega bullshit, and creativity that has made the game such a unique experience. Horseshit. We've also evaluated our plans and Heroes Esports, which is the whole purpose that Heroes of the Storm has ever made. Blizzard wanted to make a MOBA to get into the esports to make money. That's why Heroes of the Storm existed in the first place. The Heroes Global Championship and Heroes of the Dorm, their biggest events for the game, will not return in 2019 and likely never to return again. This was another very difficult decision for us to make. The love that the community has for these programs is deeply felt by everyone who works on them, but we ultimately feel this is the right decision versus moving forward in a way that would not meet the standards that players and fans have come to expect. Blizzard, we don't expect anything from you anymore because you're not Blizzard, you're Activision. We expect Activision from you, and Activision is what we're fucking getting because that's what you fucking are. Okay? Get it through you're not fooling anybody anymore. This translates to, we know you guys really like this game. We know there's a lot of people that support it, but fuck you. That's what it means. Looking at our priorities, which is mobile platforms in China. God damn. While we don't make these decisions lightly, we do look to the future excited about what the decisions will mean for other live games. Fucking live games. You mean microtransaction riddled bullshit games like Destiny 2. And all the projects we have in the works. We appreciate all of our hardworking developers and everyone in the Blizzard community and look forward to sharing many more epic gaming experiences with you in the future. Well, you're not going to be experiencing those epic gaming experiences with us in the future because you don't make epic games anymore. You make trash. You make pig shit. You make ass fodder. This is the first one to go down, guys. Signed, dickhead and buttfuck. Okay. This is the first one to go down, you guys. Next, what could be next? What's the next Blizzard game that's going to eat shit? World of Warcraft's not doing really well at all. I've seen evidence of that just playing Final Fantasy 14 and seeing shitloads of WoW refugees, players leaving the game. Battle for Azeroth is in a worse state than Warlords of Draenor even dreamed of being in. According to some statistics, you know, they're not 100% accurate, but WoW is down to under 1.5 million subscribers. That says something. So it could be WoW. It could be StarCraft 2, because StarCraft 2, I mean, you don't hear a lot about it. They haven't updated it outside of just fixing bugs and some little balance problems here and there for a long time. They're not going to abandon Overwatch. Diablo 3 has been abandoned for a long time. But what game is going to be next? What do you guys think? Because as we were told at BlizzCon, they're shifting all their talent, which they don't have much left. Most of it's left at this point. They're shoving all their talent into their mobile projects. Diablo Immortal. Fucking World of Warcraft or Warcraft Go. And then they have their back-end people, you know, the people that they hardly let out of the fucking broom closet working on shit like Warcraft 3 Remastered, stuff like that. So, this is very evident. I'm sure this also has to do with the fact of how much money Blizzard's losing. Well, let's just stop calling it Blizzard. It's not Blizzard. I'm just going to say Activision from now fucking on. Okay, and if you're having a hard time thinking, well, Blizzard's still Blizzard? Oh, really? Watch this. Okay. What's the first fucking game that's here? Call of Duty Black Ops 4 is the first game that pops up. That's an Activision game. Okay? So, I don't know, guys. What do you think? This is definitely, I mean, Blizzard is gone, and Activision has been ruining every IP they have for a long time now. And now it's finally coming to a head, and we're seeing everything. So, what do you think, guys? Go ahead and comment down below. What do you guys think about this? Now is a better time than any to abandon this company and not buy or play or microtransaction anything in their games ever again, because the company's going down. This is the exact pattern Sierra Studios and other companies have followed right before Activision completely 100% liquidated them. Now, Activision's not going to liquidate Blizzard in the same way because the brand name is worth too much. So they're always going to be called Activision Blizzard at this point, and they'll hold on to the Warcraft IP, maybe the Starcraft IP, the Diablo IP for as long as they can. But this is all the proof you need, guys. The games you're playing now that Blizzard, Activision has made that aren't getting any better will never get better. They're only going to get worse. Don't expect any super huge big games, and if you do, they're going to be riddled with microtransactions because that's what Activision does. So, anyway, guys, this has been Raziel. It's late at night, but I figured I need to make this video. I saw this news break, and it's sad, but at the same time, they have every fucking ounce of it coming their way, and they deserve it. But follow me on Twitch and Twitter. Go ahead, guys, and hit the subscribe button if you like my content and the little alert bell. And I will be back really soon with more content. And as always, keep it real.